Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. It's Amin here with Sirah Masters, developing the Muslim mindset for success. I don't usually get personal, but I wanted to, you know, take you through a little story of something that really deeply affected me, influenced my life. I've been spending the last 10 days with people that I got to know very closely over those 10 days. And we were learning about each other, obviously, how we are and what made us the way we are. And what I realized is, probably the number one thing that made me who I am today is that when I was young, 11, 12 years old, my dad made sure I went to his home country of Algeria. That one thing changed my life in a very significant way. And so I wanted to just take you through this so maybe you can take lessons from it, you can implement a similar thing in your life. So before going to Algeria, I was kind of, you know, between the UK and the UAE. And that's all I knew. Going to Algeria, thinking of Algeria, I thought, you know, I knew there was a civil war there going on before. And I thought, you know, it's like a village. I thought this country, which is now the biggest country in Africa, extremely huge country, I thought it was like a village. I just didn't know anything about it. When I got there, it's just amazing. And going there every summer for many years made me, I can say, in a significant way, made me who I am now. So how is that? Firstly, cultural differences. I learned how people are different, how every people has the good and the bad in them, and you can really appreciate the good and take the good and leave the bad, and maybe you'll find some of that bad in you, and when you see it in other people, you know that it's bad and you can try and get rid of it from yourself. Another thing I gained is the language, is that being there in a country where no one spoke English, I was forced to learn Arabic and even practice some of my French. So that was, I made a video about that already, as very, very impactful on my life. Because although Algerian Arabic isn't the closest kind of dialect to Fusha, to the classical Arabic, it gave me a grammatical base to be able to learn the Fusha Arabic and to understand the Quran more and more from that confidence. The other thing I gained was character development. You know, when you're in a country, a new country, firstly, you're going to develop anyway. Secondly, spending time with family, distant family, you know, more distant family that you don't live with per se, that's going to develop you as well, because you have to navigate certain things. With your friends, you pick them. And so if you don't like how someone is, you probably wouldn't become a friend with them. But with family, you kind of have to deal with it. And so being put in that position, similar to being at work, at workplace, you're forced to be with these people and you're forced to learn how to interact in the best way, how to compromise and not compromise, know when to stand up for something and know to when to let something go. These just things are amazing. And I feel like people that have bigger families and that interact with their families and you know, distant family, I mean, cousins, aunts, uncles, grandparents, those people become rich socially. They know how to deal with other people. So that's something definitely that I got. Another thing is it made me harder. Definitely, it made me a tougher person. Because in Algeria, people, especially back then, for example, they didn't have running water in their houses a lot of cities. So what would happen is a truck would come with a big water tank and they'd have to pump it into their tank. And you'd have to be very conservative with how much water you use because you only had a limited amount of water and the truck only came every now and then. There was no internet. People kind of lived a slower life. You know, and you kind of embrace that and you learn the benefits of living a slower life and kind of just chilling and just sitting outside with your family and not having a phone to use and not having internet to use and just connecting with people. You know, I remember especially my uncle, who's much older than me. He's probably, wow, like 40 or 50 years older than me. He's someone I wouldn't generally talk to because it's a bit awkward because of the huge gap we have. But because there was no internet and we were just sitting around, we were forced to talk. And I benefited from him, from some of his wisdoms. They made me respect him more and it made us closer, you know. So that's another great benefit. So back to being hard. You know, I would go there. I would see how people are much younger than me, but they're working. Like they work full time. You know, 14 years old, 16 years old. They're working full time. People in the heat, just dealing with it. People, you know, having to go and get water from the well, for example, and then bring it back or carry it in these big jugs. You know, people in electricity cutting out. People without much money, all this stuff, it makes you realize how soft you are sometimes. You know, me being probably like you in the top 5% most wealthy people in the world, or top 5 or 10% at least. When you go here and you see people who, yeah, there's a huge middle class in Algeria, it's not the poorest country, but you see people living, you know, lower than you, and so you kind of appreciate what you've got, and you just realize, I've got to man up. You know, I've got to kind of get a bit tougher, because this is real life, and this is how most people are living in the world. And I might be in a bubble now, but that bubble may pop. And so let me be strong. Allah loves the strong Muslim. Let me be resilient. Another thing to do with resilience is that Algerian people, and people outside of the West in general, are much more direct people. You know, they'll say, if you're fat, they won't say you're fat, but they won't not comment on it either. They might say, hey, you should do sport. You should work out a bit, you know, so they'll be pretty direct with you. And so, you know, people take less offense over there. So again, it's like a cultural thing of learning how to deal with other cultures, appreciating other cultures, appreciating some of the benefits of being direct as well. Even though it might be hurtful to you emotionally, there are benefits to it, no doubt. So that's another thing. Another benefit I took was to see how Islam is practiced in Algeria, how different people perceive scholars from different countries, and to learn also about the whole history of Algeria and its connection to Islam, and how culture and history really affects how strongly people connect with their Islamic tradition. So for example, in Algeria, the French colonized for over 130 years. And finally, after that long period of time, the Algerians fought them back and got independence for their country. And that whole revolution, that whole overthrowing of the colonizer was done with a very Islamic narrative. And because of that today, Algerians are very strong Muslims. They're very connected to their Islamic heritage. And that helps in their basic faith, in their day-to-day faith, in making dua, because these things are ingrained in the culture itself. So I don't want to go on too long. I just think that if you can, go to your parents' country, if you don't already. Go as often as possible. Even though people are different to you, don't be snobby, don't be arrogant. Learn how they live their life. They're no lower than you, you're no higher than them. You know, they've been influenced by their culture, just how you've been influenced by your culture. And so go and learn from them, take the good from them, appreciate them. And if you find they have negative traits, look in yourself if you have those negative traits so you can get rid of them. And inshallah, I do believe it will increase your iman, and it will help you see that there is good in the world. You know, that Muslims are doing okay in a lot of parts of the world, and their iman is still there. Walhamdulillah. So I hope you enjoyed, and leave comment at the bottom on your experiences of traveling to different countries. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.